What's up, guys? This is Adam Smith from the Commander Smiths, and today it's proxy time. I'm working on Crucible of Worlds today, so I'm kind of going to go through how I pick everything out and what I decide to do. So first off, I wanted to show kind of where I got the art from and everything. So one of my first steps is to actually look and see what options we have here. So these are all the printings of Crucible of Worlds. In my opinion, I like the original look of it. So I kind of chose this one to use. Well, actually not the pre-release one. I don't have that in there, but I'm using this format here. And actually the best art I could find. So I did a Google search for Crucible of Worlds full art. And normally I like to get this number a lot higher, closer to 1,000 on each of these if I can. But this actually turned out pretty good. So I actually went to the website and pulled up the art and got a pretty good quality one. And so this is what I have right now. So first things first, I loaded that in, loaded this in from Scryfall. And then actually I have our logo that's to finish the things off here. So what I'm going to do first, I'm going to grab this little guy here and just start messing with this, getting everything filled in here. So you can just hold it down. And let's make sure there's nothing there, and then I'll zoom in. So control plus, I want to make sure I get close here. All right, everything looks good there. So we're going to move over to here, get up there, and it doesn't have to be exactly perfect, but you want to catch as much as you can here. You gotta get that. Okay, so let's control Z to back that up. So if you can't get it all, I'm going to shift, put my cursor there, try to grab all of that. Yeah, because I can edit this all out later, but I want to make sure that I have everything in it because I can't edit it back in. And then we'll go up here, grab this guy, get everything in there, Crucible. So this is going to be an interesting proxy to make here, because there isn't a lot. From first glance, I'm like, okay, how am I going to get this all to what parts I'm going to make pop out, what parts am I going to do, you know, in front of the card, behind the card, what is the unique part of this card? But I kind of test wrote it just to see, you know, I did a little bit before I started recording to see if there's some interesting stuff, and I think I have some good ideas what I want to do with this card. So we're going to shrink this down. So I just copied the image from over here, and then I paste it over here. So let's get this fitting. Try to fit that perfect, because I won't mess with that anymore. It'll just be more on cropping it. So I think here I want to pull part of this in, because I think what I want to do is use this world to go over the overlay this and part of this here. So we're going to have it be right about there. And then let's pick up. I have to say yes to that. All right. Image crop. Oh. Apply. Okay. Okay. Now I should be able to crop it. Crop. And we will go here to there just to start off, and we'll bring it in a little bit. I see I have this. I'm going to get rid of this when we do the editing here in a little bit. That looks pretty good. So let's do that. Let's zoom in a little bit, kind of see here. All right, cool. I think that works out. All right, so first things first, let's start stamping stuff out of here. So Alt, click, let go, click again. Now I can go here, and we are going to get rid of this guy right there. So the best way to do that is make it really precise. We're going to grab right there, like that, back to our stamp tool. There, got rid of that. All right. Now we got to deselect this. Okay, so now I think the next thing I typically will do is drop this down to kind of see, all right, what stuff can I bring to the front? What stuff can I keep in the background? So first things first, I think we will mess with this. Now I said before, what I like to do here is I like to you to be able to see part of this. So we do want that casting cost to still be there so people can see. If they don't know Crucible of Worlds, they want to see. Or if you wanted to, you don't want to have to look up your phone. So I'll drop the opacity down to, you know, 59. Let's see here. We'll do that. So you can, now, see, that's a little too much, I think. Yeah, you can still kind of see it, I guess. But we're going to bring that up a little bit more. So let's go to 65 there. And let's start here. Get rid of that. And we'll just fill this whole thing in like that. Now, typically when I finish the card, I bring everything back up to about between 60 and 70. So that's what my... A little tough to see, but most people should know what it is, but you can see that if you really look in there, there's just a lot going on in this spot. So that might be a little more difficult. Still trying to decide if I want to keep that there. I may change that. You know what? I'm going to back that up a little bit. So that's a nice thing. Control Z, that just gets everything away. So we're going to go a little higher with that and do the same exact thing. And actually what you could do is we keep this down. We start on this side because the world you can see pretty well. And then as we go across, once we get over to that 3, I'll get on this little arc there. We'll bring it a little brighter. So let's go up to 78. So you can... Oh, you know what? I'm going the wrong way with it. We want to go the other way with it. So we'll go to 40. There we go. Now you can see that. I may even go a little bit less with that. Let's go 40 exactly there. Okay, that's better. So we'll just end with that line there. So now you can see the whole thing. Let's see what it's going to look like at 70. So you can see it pretty well. And you still have that feel of the world going in front of that. So let's see here. We'll move now down here. Now this, I don't care about. I don't want this necessarily to be here. It can be there, cannot be there. Typically don't want this symbol in there. So with that, we're just going to completely get rid of. Get a little closer. And we'll just go like that. Bring it in. Because then we get that whole feel of the world going in front of the card. Oh, see, and I don't like being able to see that. So I'll control Z. So a lot of times you hold it down and you get to a point where you're getting close, let go of the mouse so that your control Z, you're not having to redo all that over again. So I keep doing that a little bit. And pretty close there. All right. And the thing is you could use this tool over here, but sometimes it doesn't pick up everything the way I want to get it. So that's, and a lot of times I do use like this fading tool. I'll show you really quick, but I'll just, so I'll get it so it kind of goes over on purpose, you know, a little bit of each. So let's see if we even like that. So I zoom out like that or control Z. So yeah, I definitely like, do I? I don't know. Yeah, I like this version better, I think. Let me see that again if we go just a little bit. Right there, there might have been a little too much. There we go. That might actually be kind of nice. So I've been using this fading tool a little bit more lately because I used to just do crisp lines all the time, but it kind of adds a little bit of shadow to it too. All right, so we'll keep it like that. So some other things, let's see. I was kind of thinking I might mess with this a little bit because that'll give, there just might be too much here. So let's just mess with it a little bit and see what happens, see how it looks. Let's just do it quick. Just want to see. So a lot of times it's just a test to see if I like that. And it almost just seems like it's coming out of nowhere. Unless it had an exit over here, that might be better. So I don't think I like messing with that. So this is actually a pretty easy one. I'm trying to decide if I want to add any other things in here before we start messing with the symbol. Sometimes I'll could bring this out so it's just the world. Let's see what that looks like. So the text is just on the world below. So it's a lot of testing and seeing, you know, what it looks like. And I don't know if I like it. Looks weird because it almost looks like this is in front of the world. So that doesn't make any sense. It looks like one of the paintings where you have the stairs going every which way. It's like which way is on top and which way is on bottom. So that's actually kind of interesting that way. But I think that way is probably better. I don't know. That was kind of a cool effect that it was doing there. So let's move into the next part. We will do... So we have this thing up here. I know it's being sucked in through here. Kind of looks like a little butthole. So what I wanted to do actually was add our symbol there, right in the middle of the butthole. Just square in the middle. So I got to do the same thing I was doing with the card. Make sure I catch... Lately, that's not been catching that top part. So I have to make sure I get all that. Otherwise, it doesn't look like a circle when I go back. So we go back here. Paste. Let's shrink that bad boy. Get her down. Get it down. Even more. And actually, I'm going to want to zoom in here. So, and then we're going to have to do a little tilt with this one as well. So we're going to get it up here. Kind of, I still want that feel of why it's there. Because otherwise, if I just put it there, it's just like, well, you just have a circle in the middle. But you have to kind of make it look like it belongs there. It belongs in the butthole. So there, we'll add that. And then we're going to add a little tilt to that. And then the fun part is you fade it out so it actually looks a little bit. So it's not as noticeable there. I'll zoom out and kind of look at that. Oh, yeah. That looks good. So there you go. That's Crucible of Worlds right there. So that's going to be the proxy of the week for this week. Tune in next time. I'm going to keep doing this, doing segments here with new proxies that I'll be working on, and you can kind of see what stuff I decide. And you can also decide if you wanted to add, like if you like something else I did better, like if you wanted, like I mentioned about taking this out. This could be an interesting, oops, you got to make sure you have your layers. That's one thing I'll run into a lot. Make sure you're on the right layer. So here, this could be an interesting looking card. It doesn't make sense because this is the universe and it's supposed to be behind the world, but looking at it, it looks crazy when it's like that. So I might have two versions of this one and have you guys vote on that as well, because I kind of like the way this looks. It, like I said, doesn't make sense at all, but it looks kind of crazy. So thanks for watching, you guys. Subscribe to our channel. That's the best way to support us. So leave comments below. Thanks a lot.